Hey everyone, Percy Jules here. Today I'm going to talk about moving your Studio One sound sets to another location on your computer or to an external hard drive or something like that. Now, first of all, what are sound sets? Now, let's first take a look at the manual. It says the loops, samples, and instrument presets included with Studio One are bundled into sound sets. So basically, sound sets is a collection of files that Studio One uses to produce some sounds. Now, I'm not sure that that's the best explanation, but I hope you know what I mean. And how many sound sets it concerns all depends on which version of Studio One you're using. Now, those files obviously take up some space on your computer. Let's take a look at this. My Studio One sound sets take up 20.5 gigabytes on my hard disk. And by default, they're saved to the system drive. And that already is the first reason why you might want to move them somewhere else. Because you simply want as little as possible files on your system drive. And another reason is, especially if you're talking about music production, it's always a good idea to separate your sound libraries and your samples and your loops and things like that from your system drive, because your system drive already has to run your DAW. And if it also has to read and write your sound libraries and your loops and your audio files, you know, it's very likely you're gonna overload your disk. So it's always good to have a dedicated disk for sound sets and sound libraries and samples and loops and all those kind of things. Now, before you actually move your sound sets to another hard disk, make sure that that hard disk meets some requirements. Now, one of the requirements concerns speed. You know, again, in music production, speed is very important. So if you're gonna use, let's say, a conventional hard disk, take a look at the spinning speed, or whatever it's called, and make sure that it is at least 7200 RPM. I mean, you could use a disk that is a little bit slower, so 5400 RPM for instance, but that obviously makes it much more likely that you're gonna run into some errors, or that you're gonna see that disk is too slow notification every once in a while. So what is recommended is 7200 RPM, or use an SSD, a solid state drive. Now, the same is true for your connection to that hard drive. So make sure that it is either a USB 3 connection, USB 2 is probably gonna be a little bit too slow, or FireWire, although FireWire is, you know, it seems to be phasing out more and more, or eSATA or Thunderbolt. Anyway, make sure that the connection is fast enough. Now, to move our sound sets, we first have to know where they are on our computer, of course. So let's go to Studio One. And as you can see, I've created a little song. So very simple song, 3 drum tracks, a bass and a synth. And let's first listen to this little song. Masterpiece, obviously. Okay, remember this song? For many reasons, by the way, but for now, we're gonna come back to this in a minute. But first, how do we find the location of the sound sets on your computer? Now, from here, you can just open the browser, then go to Files, and here you should see a folder called Sound Sets. Now, I've got it right here, and if I click on that folder, you should see all the sound sets in that folder. Now, if I click on one of the sound sets, you can see that it consists of loops. So a lot of loops. And it also has presets, and it also has samples. All right. Now, to find the location of this sound set, you can simply right click and go to Show in Explorer. Okay, if you click that, the Explorer opens up and shows the location of those sound sets. All right, now this is a PC. It should work very similarly on a Mac. Anyway, this is how you do that. And if you go up a level, this is the folder we're talking about. This is what we want to move somewhere else. So how do you actually move the folder? Well, that's actually very, very simple. It is basically the same as moving any other folder on your computer. So as you can see to the right, I have my sound set folder. the folder I want to move. To the left, I've opened another Explorer window and I've gone to a location on my L drive. The L drive represents a hard drive, a dedicated hard drive on my computer, dedicated to sound libraries and things like that. And as you can see, I've already got some libraries from Native Instruments, Spectrasonics, XLN Audio. And as you can see, I've also already created a PreSonus folder. And that is where I want this sound set folder to go. Now, moving the folder is as simple as shift clicking on the folder you want to move and then dragging it to the desired location. And as you can see, it's a relatively large folder, so it might take some time to complete. And there you go. Now, the sound sets have actually already been moved, as you can see, but we're not completely done yet. So let's go back to Studio One and let's go back to that same song as before. Remember that masterpiece? Let's try to open that again. I've got it right here, so let's click it and we get a message saying 17 files are missing. That doesn't look good. But you know what? We're gonna ignore this. I'm gonna close this message and let's just play the song and we'll see what happens. Now what just happened? Well, when I pressed play, you could hear some sounds. You could hear the drum sounds, but you couldn't hear the bass sound and you couldn't hear the synth sounds. Now why is that? Well, the drum tracks are actually audio tracks and the audio files are stored in the same location as the song. And that hasn't changed. They're not part of the sound sets. The bass track and the synth track are actually MIDI tracks. And the MIDI information coming from these tracks is supposed to trigger audio files stored in the sound sets. The problem is that Studio One doesn't know where the sound sets are. You know, so I first have to tell Studio One where to look for those sound sets. Now, how do you do that? Well, it's actually very simple. Let's first go to the Studio One menu up here. Then go to Options, go to Locations, and go to Sound Sets. Now, this is actually the old location where the sound sets used to be stored. Now they're in a new location. And we have to add that location to this list so that Studio One knows where to look. Okay, so click Add, then look for the sound sets. So it's on the L drive, PreSonus, Sound Sets, and select Folder. Now, if I click apply, you will see that Studio One is already scanning that location and that should be it. Okay, now click OK. And now again, let's play this song and see what happens. And that's it. Okay, so that is how you move your Studio One sound sets to another location on your computer. I hope this helps. Thank you for watching, and I will talk to you soon.